The incredible rise and reign of Elon Musk. As CEO of SpaceX and Tesla, founder of The Boring Company, and co-founder of OpenAI and Neuralink, Musk seems to be everywhere all at once, pushing all kinds of futuristic technologies. He said he wouldn't be happy until we've escaped Earth and colonized Mars. But who is this guy littering the headlines all the time? In this video, we will look at the incredible rise and reign of Elon Musk. But before we begin, ensure you subscribe to our channel and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for timely updates of our new uploads. Let's get it on! Between space rockets, electric cars, solar batteries, and the billions he's made along the way, Musk is basically a real-life Tony Stark, which is why he served as an inspiration for Marvel's 2008 Iron Man film. But it hasn't always been smooth sailing for Musk. We take a look at how he went from getting bullied in school to small-time entrepreneur to CEO of two major companies that seem like they're straight out of science fiction, and how he almost went broke along the way. Elon Musk was born on June 28, 1971 in Pretoria, South Africa. Musk's mother, May, is a professional dietitian and model. She has appeared on boxes of Special K cereal and the cover of Time magazine. In 2017, at the age of 69, she landed a contract with CoverGirl. After their parents divorced in 1979, 9-year-old Musk and his younger brother Kimball decided to live with their father. It wasn't until after the move was made that his notoriously troubled relationship with his dad began to emerge. It was not a good idea, Musk said in a Rolling Stone interview about moving in with his father. In 1983, at the age of 12, Musk sold a simple game called Blastar to a computer magazine for $500. He described it as a trivial game, but better than Flappy Bird. Still, Musk's school days weren't easy. He was once hospitalized after being beaten by bullies. The bullies threw Musk down a set of stairs and beat him until he blacked out. After graduating from high school, he moved to Canada with his mother May, his sister Tosca, and his brother Kimball, and spent 2 years studying at Queen's University in Kingston, Ontario. But he finished his studies at the University of Pennsylvania, earning degrees in physics and economics. While studying at the University of Pennsylvania, Musk and a classmate rented out a 10-bedroom flat house and turned it into a nightclub. The move, which Musk undertook with Hideo Resi, was one of his first entrepreneurial experiments. After graduation, Musk traveled to Stanford University to study for his PhD, but he barely started the program before leaving it. He deferred his admission after only 2 days in California, deciding to test his luck in the dot-com boom that was just getting underway. He never returned to finish his studies at Stanford. With his brother Kimball, Musk launched Zip2. A cluster of Silicon Valley investors helped them fund the company, which provided city travel guides to newspapers like the New York Times and Chicago Tribune. While Zip2 got off the ground, Musk literally lived in the office and showered at a local YMCA. The hard work paid off when Compaq bought Zip2 in a deal worth $341 million in cash and stock, earning Musk $22 million in profits. Musk next started X.com, an online banking company. He launched the company in 1999 using $10 million of the money he got from the Zip2 sale. About a year later, X.com merged with Confinity, a financial startup co-founded by Peter Thiel, to form PayPal. Musk was named the CEO of the newly minted PayPal, but it wouldn't last long. In October 2000, he started a huge fight among the PayPal co-founders by pushing them to move their servers from the free Unix operating system to Microsoft Windows. PayPal co-founder and then CTO Max Levchin pushed back hard. While Musk was en route to Australia for a much-needed vacation, the PayPal board fired him and made Thiel the new CEO. "That's the problem with vacations," Musk told Fortune years later about his ill-fated trip in late 2000. But things worked out for Musk. He made another windfall when eBay bought PayPal in late 2002. As PayPal's single biggest shareholder, he netted $165 million of the $1.5 billion price eBay paid. Even before the PayPal sale, Musk was dreaming up his next move, including a wild plan to send mice or plants to Mars. In early 2002, he founded the company that would be known as Space Exploration Technologies, or SpaceX, with $100 million of the money received from the PayPal sale. Musk's goal was to make spaceflight cheaper by a factor of 10. Another early vehicle was named after the song Puff the Magic Dragon. The name of the spacecraft, the Dragon, was Musk's jab at skeptics who told him SpaceX would never be able to put vehicles into space. SpaceX's long-term goal is to make colonizing Mars affordable. Musk has said that SpaceX won't file for an initial public offering until what he calls the Mars Colonial Transporter is regularly flying. He has also been keeping plenty busy here on Earth, particularly with Tesla Motors. In 2004, he made the first of what would be $70 million of total investments in Tesla, an electric car company co-founded by veteran startup executive Martin Eberhard. Musk took an active product role at Tesla, helping develop its first car, the Roadster. The all-electric Roadster debuted in 2006 when Musk was serving as Tesla's chairman. He is now also its CEO. As if that wasn't enough, he came up with the idea for Solar City, a solar energy company. Musk gave his cousins Peter and Lyndon Rive the working capital to get Solar City off the ground in 2006. In late 2016, Tesla bought Solar City in a $2.6 billion deal. In 2007, Musk staged a boardroom coup at Tesla, first ousting Eberhard from his CEO seat, and then from the company's board and executive suites entirely. In 2008, with the financial crisis seriously limiting his options, Musk personally saved Tesla from bankruptcy. He invested $40 million in Tesla and loaned the company $40 million more. Not coincidentally, he was named the company's CEO the same year. But between SpaceX, Tesla, and Solar City, Musk nearly went broke. He describes 2008 as the worst year of his life. Tesla kept losing money, and SpaceX was having trouble launching its Falcon 1 rocket. By 2009, Musk was living off personal loans just to survive. His personal life was in upheaval too. His wife Justine, a Canadian author, got divorced in 2008. The couple got married in 2000. Their first son, Nevada, died of SIDS at 10 weeks old. The Musks later went on to have twins, and then triplets. Musk started dating actress Tallulah Riley later that year. They went on to get married in 2010, then divorced in 2012. In July 2013, they remarried. In December 2014, Musk filed for divorce but withdrew the paperwork. In March 2016, Riley filed for divorce. That divorce was finalized in October. Right around Christmas 2008, Musk got two pieces of good news. SpaceX had landed a $1.5 billion contract with NASA to deliver supplies into space. And Tesla finally found more outside investors. By June 2010, Tesla held a successful initial public offering. The company raised $226 million in the IPO, becoming the first car company to go public since Ford in 1956. To get his finances back on track, Musk sold shares worth about $15 million in the offering. His extraordinary career was starting to get noticed in other circles too, most notably in Hollywood. Robert Downey Jr.'s portrayal of Tony Stark in the Iron Man movies is at least partially based on Musk. Musk even had a cameo in Iron Man 2. By the end of 2015, SpaceX had made 24 launches on assignments like resupplying the International Space Station, setting lots of records along the way. In 2016, the SpaceX Falcon 9 made the first successful ocean landing of a reusable orbital rocket. The Falcon Heavy, the successor to the Falcon 9 and the most powerful rocket SpaceX has built to date, completed a successful maiden launch in February 2018. The Falcon Heavy carried a unique payload, a dummy dubbed Starman, and Musk's personal cherry red Tesla Roadster, which was launched toward Martian orbit. Musk can't stop coming up with new ideas either, like the Hyperloop. A super high-speed train that travels in a vacuum tube, the Hyperloop could theoretically transport passengers from Los Angeles to San Francisco in 30 minutes. In a similar vein, Musk started another company in 2016, the Boring Company, which has a mission to dig a network of tunnels under and around cities for high-speed, no-traffic driving. And in late 2015, the charismatic billionaire co-founded OpenAI, a nonprofit dedicated to researching artificial intelligence and ensuring it doesn't destroy humanity. More recently, Musk announced he was stepping down from the board of OpenAI in February 2018 to avoid any potential conflicts of interest with Tesla, which has made strides into artificial intelligence for its self-driving car technology. Musk founded one more company, this one in 2017, Neuralink, which is trying to build devices that can be implanted inside the human brain. The tech guru started dating Aquaman actress Amber Heard, but the two broke up in 2017 after a year of dating. He later said in an interview with Rolling Stone that the breakup was very hard on him. The year was a bit rocky from a political standpoint as well. Musk joined President Trump's Business Advisory Council, a move that caused a huge public backlash. He initially defended the move, but he quit after Trump pulled the U.S. out of the Paris Agreement on climate change. Musk said he tried to convince Trump not to withdraw. In the spring of 2018, there was a new development in Musk's personal life. He and musician Grimes struck up a relationship. They reportedly hit it off after they both made the same nerdy joke about artificial intelligence. Musk ran into some trouble in 2018 when he sent a tweet declaring he was considering taking Tesla private at $420 per share and had already secured funding. Just a few days later, the SEC sent Tesla subpoenas about the company's plans to go private and Musk's comments. By September, the SEC had formally filed a lawsuit against Musk, accusing him of making false and misleading statements. Musk settled with the SEC, which resulted in both him and Tesla paying a $20 million fine and him agreeing to step down as chairman of Tesla's board. In November 2019, Musk debuted a new Tesla vehicle, the Cybertruck, Tesla's first and very highly anticipated pickup truck. Since the unveiling, Musk has been spotted a few times cruising around in the truck, including a night out to dinner at Nobu with Grimes. On the 7th of January 2021, Musk was named the world's richest man, overtaking Amazon founder Jeff Bezos. The 49-year-old's net worth is now pegged at a staggering $186 billion, making him $1.5 billion richer than Bezos, who has held the top spot since October 2017. His story is tough, eventful, risky, but most importantly, inspiring. Do you think Musk will remain the world's wealthiest man? Let us know in the comment section below. Also, give us a like, share the video, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for timely updates of our weekly uploads.